Assalamu alaikum. 8 a.m. This is Bangladesh Betar, broadcasting on the morning of Wednesday, the 20th of Bhadra, the 29th of Safar, and September the 4th. The news read by Taslima Omar. First, the headlines. Chief Advisor assures business leaders of all possible support. Dr. Muhammad Yunus says interim government is in freedom of press and wants to see vibrant media in country. UAE grants amnesty to all 57 convicted Bangladeshis who staged demonstration expressing solidarity to student people movement. Joint operation to recover illegal arms begins last midnight. Education advisor urges all to end forced resignation and harassment of teachers. At least 51 people have been killed in a Russian missile strike on Poltava in Ukraine. And Bangladesh clinch landmark test series against Pakistan. President and chief advisor greet Bangladesh national cricket team. Now on to the details. Chief Advisor Professor Dr. Muhammad Yunus has assured business leaders of all possible support to take Bangladesh's industrial growth to a new height. He made the expression while a business delegation paid him a courtesy call at the State Guest House, Jamuna, yesterday. President of the International Chamber of Commerce, Bangladesh, Mahbubur Rahman, led the business delegation. The chief advisor said the student people revolution has ushered in a new era of hope in the country and the interim government is committed to carrying out much-needed reforms in industry, finance and manufacturing. The business leaders raised the issue of recent unrest in the garment and pharmaceutical sectors, saying they suspect the factories were vandalized at the instigation of outsiders, including groups living outside the country. They demanded stepped-up security in the industrial areas, saying the image of the country will be dented if safety and security are not ensured in the factories. Dr. Muhammad Yunus said his government is committed to protecting the factories from violence and attacks. Chief Advisor Professor Dr. Muhammad Yunus has said the interim government believes in the freedom of media and it wants to see vibrant media in Bangladesh. He said this in a meeting with the editors of 20 leading newspapers at the State Guest House, Jamuna, in the capital yesterday. After the meeting, Chief Advisor's Press Secretary Shafiqul Alam and Deputy Press Secretary Muhammad Abul Kalam Azad Mujumdar briefed newsmen at the Foreign Service Academy in the capital yesterday. Shafiqul Alam said many black laws and regulations are impeding the freedom of media and those will be removed or amended. The press secretary said during the meeting, many editors suggested forming a media commission to ensure media freedom in the country. Regarding the reform in the state system, Shafiqul Alam said the chief advisor recently held meetings with political parties and the political leaders asked Dr. Muhammad Yunus to complete the reform work within a logical time frame. Shafiqul Alam said the chief advisor mentioned that the student people revolution created an opportunity for the state repairing and it should be utilized. The press secretary said Dr. Muhammad Yunus stressed creating a national unity to make the reforms sustainable. He said the editors also talked about constitutional reform and reforming the law commission and the public service commission. Meanwhile, attending the meeting with the editors at the State Guest House, Jamuna, the chief advisor said the United Arab Emirates, UAE, granted amnesty for all 57 Bangladeshis earlier convicted by the country's federal court. The chief advisor said all 57 Bangladeshis have been granted pardon by UAE President Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed Al Nahyan. Chief Advisor's Press Secretary Shafiqul Alam confirmed the newsman, saying the pardoned people will be deported to Bangladesh soon. The Bangladeshi diaspora staged demonstration abroad expressing their solidarity to the student people movement against the autocratic Sheikh Hasina government. Meanwhile, Chief Advisor Professor Dr. Muhammad Yunus has expressed his gratitude to President of the United Arab Emirates, UAE, Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed Al Nahyan, for granting amnesty to all 57 Bangladeshis. In a letter to the UAE president, the chief advisor said this act of clemency following their telephone conversation not only exemplifies the UAE president's compassionate leadership, but also serves as a conduit for strengthening the enduring bond of fraternity between the two nations. The chief advisor said UAE president's magnanimous decision to annul their sentences has been met with profound relief and appreciation, in particular by the families of those involved and by our broader countrymen in Bangladesh as well as our community in the UAE in general. Kuwait will recruit more human resources, including skilled workers from Bangladesh, in its effort to boost ties with the South Asian country. Outgoing Ambassador of Kuwait in Dhaka, Faisal Mutlaq Aladwani, made the comments when he paid his farewell call on Chief Advisor Professor Dr. Muhammad Yunus at the State Guest House Jamuna in the capital yesterday. During the meeting, the Chief Advisor praised the Kuwait envoy, saying he was a wonderful friend of Bangladesh and hoped that he would continue to play this role in the coming days too. The outgoing Kuwait envoy said more than 3 lakh Bangladeshis are working in the Gulf state and his country is keen to recruit more Bangladeshis. Collaboration on economic engagement, defense, the Rohingya crisis, Palestinian issue and energy cooperation were highlighted during the meeting. This is Bangladesh Petar giving you the news. This news will also be available on our website at www.betar.gov.bd. The court has acquitted BNP chairperson Begum Khalida Zia in 5 defamation cases lodged against her. The court of Dhaka Additional Chief Metropolitan Magistrate Mahbubul Haq ordered to acquit her in 4 cases, while the Court of Dhaka Additional Chief Metropolitan Magistrate Tofazal Hussain ordered to acquit her in another defamation case yesterday. Begum Khalida Zia's lawyer Masood Ahmed Talukdar confirmed the matter to Newsmen. A joint operation will begin across the country from midnight last night in an effort to recover illegal firearms. The Home Affairs Ministry in a statement yesterday informed this. Earlier, the interim government suspended all license of firearms issued during the Awami League government. The government also asked gun owners to submit their firearms and ammunition along with the suspended licenses to the relevant police stations within yesterday. Education and Planning Advisor Wahiduddin Mahmood has urged all concerned to end forced resignation and harassment of teachers. He made the call while discussing with the officials of the Ministry of Education at the Secretariat yesterday. Education and Planning Advisor said teachers and officials who were accused of corruption and misdeeds will be investigated and action will be taken through appropriate authorities. At least 51 people have been killed and 271 others injured in a Russian missile strike on the city of Poltava in central Ukraine. A military academy and a nearby hospital were hit. Ukraine's land forces confirmed that military personnel were killed in the attack. President Volodymyr Zelensky promised that what he called Russian scum would pay for the attack. Moscow has not commented on the attack. Bangladesh made history by winning a test series in Pakistan, defeating the hosts 2-0 in a 2-match series in Rawalpindi. The Tigers claimed the victory in the first match by 10 wickets and followed it up with a 6-wicket win in the second match, marking a new chapter in its cricketing history. Chasing 185 to win on the final day, Bangladesh scaled the target with 6 wickets to spare. Notably, this is Bangladesh's second test series win on foreign soil. The first time they won a test series away from home was in 2009 when they toured the West Indies for a 2-match contest. Meanwhile, President Mohammad Shahbuddin and Chief Advisor Dr. Muhammad Yunus congratulated Bangladesh national cricket team for their historic test series win against Pakistan. Besides, Youth and Sports Advisor Asif Mahmood Shojib Bhuiya also congratulated Bangladesh cricket team. Finally, weather in Forecast Valley till 1 this afternoon says there is no inland river port warning and no signal is to be hoisted. To end the news, the main points again. Chief Advisor assures business leaders of all possible support. UAE grants amnesty to all 57 convicted Bangladeshis who have staged demonstration expressing solidarity to student people movement. Joint operation to recover illegal arms begins last midnight. At least 51 people have been killed in a Russian missile strike on Poltava in Ukraine. And Bangladesh clinched landmark test series against Pakistan. President and chief advisor greet Bangladesh national cricket team. That is the end of the news. This news will also be available on our website at www.beta.gov.bd. Our next bulletin will be at 9 this morning in Bangla.